It is my pleasant duty to introduce Professor Partha Pratim Chakrabarti, the speaker for this session. Partha Pratim Chakrabarti received BTech and PhD degrees in computer science and engineering from Indian Institute of Technology, Kharagpur, 1985 and 1988, respectively. Please see the two things. One, we are talking of direct PhDs in a big way. There are many direct PhD students who entered, in last 1.5 years. He was a direct PhD 3 decades back. And the most interesting, important thing is 1985 and 1988. What's the difference? 3 years. So he completed his PhD in 3 years after BTech. Please understand. Since 1988, he has been a faculty member at IIT Kharagpur, where he is currently the director and a professor of Department of Computer Science and Engineering. And as he was saying this morning also to me, you see, that is permanent. This is temporary. Directorship is temporary. But that he is a faculty member of Computer Science Department, I think that's permanent, and that gives him more pleasure. He has published over 250 research papers and several major projects. His area of interest includes AI, CAD for VLSI, embedded system, algorithm design, and reliable and fault-tolerant systems. Professor Chakrabarti was the recipient of several honors, including he is the PGM holder of IIT Kharagpur, President's Gold Medal, Swarna Jayanti Fellowship, Shanti Sharup Bhatnagar Award, and fellows of all the academies. All the academies? All the four?
No.
As far as academic accomplishment is concerned, I think Partha is just, his background is impeccable. He is a member of SEM and a senior member of the IEEE. And what you will realize that today, with all these backgrounds, he is a very humble and a very, very nice and a casual person whom you will love to meet. Partha.
Don't take much time. Thank you, Professor Das. It's a great pleasure to be here with all of you. And as I just mentioned a little while ago, the few permanent things in my life, one appears to be the IIT. Once I've got in 1981, I don't seem to be eligible for any other job anywhere else. So probably the rest of my life will also be there. In addition to that, as you know that now I am a teacher, but at heart, I always try to continue to believe that I am a researcher. And today, I will try to just share with you of various things that come to my mind when I... So I had asked Professor Das, who is a great friend, do I need to give a serious talk on any topic? And, then I realized that being a director, you have to sign about 400 signatures per day. All bills from above some 20,000 rupees, everything you have to sign, So you become fossilized very quickly. You all know many teachers are also fossilized in this system, so don't worry about it. And so it was a good thing for me to try and recapitulate with you. So I won't make it too technical and just share with you some of my thoughts and try to, bring about what this is all about. Firstly, let me tell you that, like many of you, in spite of this modern age, we are fairly old-fashioned people. When there's Janagana Mana, there is a lump on your throat. When I go into the institute, when I see dedicated to the service of the nation, it reminds me that there is something else to everything that we do. So I would request that all of you remain a little old-fashioned. And that will help you and help us, because it has helped me in many ways. So if you look at the IIT system, which is now very famous for having transformed a lot of things in this country, this is, I think, so as I was worrying that this will not work. Unfortunately, my chotha will be left here. It doesn't matter. So the IIT system, which was established from the 1950s onwards, from the beginning stressed on research. In IIT Kharagpur, when we started the IIT system, there it started with 200 undergraduate students and 40 research scholars. And among the first people who came out doing research were really giants today. Have you heard of Mani Bhaumik, who did this eye laser technology? So there are people who were among the first PhDs of the IIT system. And then the growth of science and engineering, humanities, then sponsored research. And then we slowly we started becoming international, having centers, and the IIT system is very vibrant today with multiple interdisciplinary research, IITs collaborating with each other. And we are moving in a direction where we are technology focused, but we still are trying to broaden the horizons of what we do. Next. So in India, everything is benchmarked with cricket. So even research in IITs is benchmarked with cricket. So I have drawn some of the cricket captains. Can you recognize them? The first one symbolizes the old style of research. Maharaj Kumar of Vijayanagaram. He was a captain of the Indian team. He did not know how to play cricket. And slowly it started getting transformed in two directions. Firstly, as you see, the top three were in a sense Indian but foreign returned. They were all, you know, princes, maharajas, great, you know, very rich people, or came from the army. So that was what was the first stage till we reached, you know, Tiger Pataudi. So we have crossed in our own research that phase. Typically people coming from abroad and telling that this is how the system should run. And then slowly imbibing that spirit into the system. It still happens, but that leadership is slowly going away. And then came the 70s, if you remember. I don't know whether many of you were born or not. Ajit Wadekar, the West Indies tour, 1971, Sunil Gavaskar started, and the Indian cricket won its first overseas series. That was the homebred people. People who learned their cricket in India, but all of them learned their cricket in reasonable big cities, the first two and others. They learned it in the big cities and they became the champions. So here also in the IIT system, people started coming back. People from the IITs started doing research in the IIT system and started taking up the leadership of research in the IIT system. And it flowered, and it has started flowering. And today, as we see, you know, we have a leader of the IIT system who has done the Chandrayaan and the Mangalyaan, and that is like Kapil Dev, you know. We won something. We did something world class. So that is where we are now. And we have also moved ahead into very talented people doing very great things. But we are now seeing spurts of compromise on ethics. That is why I put in Mohammad Azharuddin. Please remember, this is what is happening. This is the scenario today. We are champions in some cases. We have got real people coming out of the IIT system who are leading the country, showing the world that we can do better than anybody else. With our approach, Kapil Dev, our approach, you know, Chandigarh, RapidX, all these things are very clear. You know, he didn't know how to speak English properly, he learned it. So people coming in and becoming champions, but then flowering many people, extremely talented and good, but then even today, people are slightly off, not citing the paper they should cite, putting some results a little bit here and there, not telling their supervisor. No, I'm telling you, when you grow rapidly, your crystals do not nurture well. And certain outliers in the system tend to cause harm in the system. They may be very good. And then we are waiting from you for the last row. We are waiting for the Sachin, we are waiting for the Saurav, and we are waiting for that cool and calm approach to world-class leadership of research in India. And I really don't know whether we are waiting for Virat Kohli, but so that is where we are in our research, you know. Here, we have to be careful. And if you look at the way we are doing research, if you look at these guys were flamboyant, don't care. I will hit 2 sixes, get out, go away. But now, here, our group, we want to win. We want to be careful, we will defend, we will be offensive, then we will have these great all-round champions who will lead the whole team. Of nobody, what? Imagine, just look at what this Mars Orbiter mission has done. What did India do? Balwinder Singh Sandhu, Madan Lal, they won India the World Cup. That is the greatness of how great leadership can transform ordinary people to do great work. And that is why we must give Dr. Radhakrishnan and ISRO the greatest of achievements. And our system and y'all are facing this scenario, the ethics scenario. They are all talented people facing the ethics scenario. And we are waiting, we the people who will be in this system for another 10, 15, 20 years, are waiting for the Tendulkar, the Saurav, the Dhoni, And as I said, I don't know whether you want to be the Virat. So benchmark ourselves. We say we are world class. Are we equal to MIT? No. Be careful. But in some cases, we are really world class. And we have to scale that up. And how do we scale that up? What is the role? What is the dream? I would like to share with you. Next. You must have heard this, seen this. Every time, you know, like Dr. Radhakrishnan and others mentioned, when you get frustrated, when you think what you want to be, you think of people like this man. In his research, every number between 1 to 10,000 was his personal friend. He knew something about that number. And there is that wonderful story of when Hardy said, "Hardy," so he used to say, every number is unique. So Hardy looked at a taxi cab number and said, "What about this?" So immediately he said, "This is the smallest number expressible as a sum of two, it's written as two cubes in two different ways. It was also the sum of two squares." So it's a very interesting thing. So when you do research, you get deep into it. You know everything about it. You want to know everything about it. You dream, you sleep, you breathe. That is those glimpses you must get during your research. That is very important. I really don't want you all to die of pneumonia and all that. But please have these people as our heroes. Just go back once or twice and think about what research means. Next. We were all luckier people. And I'll tell you, you all are not lucky. We were luckier for several reasons. I've listed out a few. When I did my BTEC, and as you said, I wanted to come back and do PhD. Or M.Tech in the country. First thing was, there is no M.Tech in computer science in IIT Kharagpur, so you can't do M.Tech. Go abroad. Then they said, PhD, oh, you have to do PhD, okay. So from B.Tech to PhD, so we'll give you 30-40 credits to do coursework first. So everything, they will first, the system will be for such that whenever you try to do something, they will say, can't be done. That was a boon for us. Since they said it can't be done, so it annoyed us. So why it can't be done? Let us try. So this, it cannot be done in India, was something that was, you know, told to us by a lot of people. For example, you all will do good research, then go abroad, spend 30-40 years abroad, and from there we'll say, you know, you should do this. So these are the things. The second thing was, we were all on our own. You all have supervisors calling you. Our supervisors never called us. Our supervisors were very benevolent. One of my professors would tell me, so when I went to him, sir, what to do in research? So he gave me three simple rules. The rules are applicable today, but not the way your faculty supervisors have told you. And I'll tell you why your faculty supervisors have told you this. But what my senior supervisors used to tell me, see, simple thing. He says, Partha, do good work. First statement was, try to do something good. Finished. Second was, if you can do something good, try to publish in a good place. If you publish in sufficiently good places, write your thesis. So when I published in sufficiently good places, and in 2 years I went and told him I want to write a thesis, he got very hassled. Hey, 2 years? What are you doing? Go and do something more. So we are very benevolent people. And we had very simple goals for excellence. Today you will get a lot of gyan about what excellence is, definition of excellence. Our was very simple. Try to do something good and try to publish in good places. Another boon that we had was low on equipment, computers, old Fortran machines. There you take a bunch of punch cards, you go and submit into the computer center, come day after tomorrow. So next day after tomorrow you go, one printout, one syntax error. Again you go punch, again go day after tomorrow. So we were very careful of what we were submitting. That whole program we ran in our heads 20 times before we went and submitted it to that person. Today you sit down, before you dictate the problem to him, he will have written the program, he will have written three variables and for I equal to 1 to n, doesn't even know the problem. We were very low on equipment. My programs used to run from morning, next day, 2 days, 3 days, simple program which will run in 2 minutes today. So I had a pillow, you know, jacket, everything, sleeping in the classroom. But the good thing was, and then people didn't have much equipment. Today, you all will go, like Professor Bhaskar Ramamurthy said, lot of equipment, NMR, this, that, produce 20, 30 graphs, confuse everybody, you know. You also know all this is raw rubbish. So what made us there was that we had to be very good in the idea. The idea had to be really good. Because we cannot compete on experimental results with others. We used to have collaborators. Some of our colleagues used to go abroad to Germany, USA, and run the experiments and come back. But in general, the ideas would be very, very strong. So even if the experimental results were not what a person in a developed country could do at that time, we would win on the merit of the intellectual capacity of that work. So that is why we were luckier. The intellectual capacity of the work had to be on a much, much higher scale. So we survived on our ideas and imaginations. Then there were some very, very simple rules. When I wrote my first paper, you know, that time typewriter, cut, 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 cut. I wrote my paper. Nicely I wrote. I went and showed it to my supervisor. He looked at it, smiled, and then he went, opened up a textbook and showed me, you know, you have done this. So I had done something very simple in computer science, those who are there. I had done something of traversal of a graph, which was done 30 years ago. So I came back completely heartbroken. And like all of you, we also have a Waldorf there. So I went to Waldorf and had good food so that, you know, relieve me of my tensions. Next time again, this time I did not type anymore. So I went and told him the idea. He says, yes, yes, this is good. I haven't seen this before. So let's write it down. So when we wrote it down, and then he said, where to send it? You know, today, you try to find the place where it comes, where it will most rapidly get published. But what we were taught, he took me to the library and showed me a journal and said, let's send it here. I said, what are you saying? Nobody in India has ever published in that journal for the last 30 years. Nobody ever. He says, no, no, even if you will get some good reviews. Some good people will read it. The good thing was that because the idea was very simple, but the idea was interesting, it was the first paper published in that top journal of AI ever by an Indian. Very simple paper. But what he ingrained to me at that point in time was that benchmark yourself with the best. Don't go for easy options. Don't go for easy options. There is something about quality, and ensure that you believe in that quality. Similarly, several other types of ethics were inbuilt around us, which we find very difficult to shrug off. Very, very difficult to shrug off. My student comes and says that, sir, we have not published a paper in 1.5 years I have come. That fellow, he has already gone to Kathmandu, Bangkok, everywhere, and published a paper, this conference, that conference. Every conference from Patna, then Bhubaneswar, and then all odd places, wherever, you know, you just have to pay registration fees. And the only people who participate in that session are the authors of the paper. So I said no. But eventually, when he got his work published in the IEEE, one of the best journals, full paper, you know, he was very happy. So this inbuilt part of quality, the inbuilt part of ethics, is most important. And that is why I said the hardships that we went through, and we went through it very happily. We went through it very happily. We were small in numbers. We knew each other's problems. I mean, we used to solve very simple problems. One of my colleagues used to try and solve how, if I have to, in a chessboard, in a chessboard, if I have to go from position IJ to another position and make the move of a knight, you know, 2.5 moves in chess, what is the minimum number of moves if I give you these two coordinates? And is there a closed form formula for it? So these funny problems we used to solve, especially in the classes, you know. Classes are all boring, still even more boring now. So we knew each other's problems. And since we did not go abroad, we were very happy. My friend Lakshmanan, who went abroad, his name became Lax Lakshman. Somebody went abroad. Somyajit Chatterjee, he became Sam Chat. We were very happy. We did not have to change our names. So, we were really luckier. And I used to always read all this stuff, you know. Constantly, we did not have the internet, but we had a very nice library. All the institutes have nice libraries. And we, you know, used to have lots of exchanges, read things. As I said, we were a little old-fashioned. We felt we were very modern, but then, you know, we were really not modern people. Next. So now, I think, just to take you through a trail of how research is done and how we go through that whole process, I'll just give you an example from modern times and show you what kind of research I engage in. Today we know these mobile systems, the automotive cars, all of them run on embedded software. Correct? These cars and all, the first time when I went to Intel in the US and they gave us a big project on automotive verification. And how did Intel start this? And how did we start working with Intel and General Motors and all on this unique set of problems? Let me explain. The head of Intel's embedded group, about 20 years ago, he had a car. Then he had a suspension problem in his car. So he went and gave it to the garage. He said, okay, you come after 2 days. After 2 days, he came back, drive, looks okay. He says, what did you do? That garage fellow said, I downloaded a patch. He says, suspension patch? So then he realized that the whole of the automotive control system has become embedded software. And once it becomes embedded software, then the whole correctness issues become extremely complex. So how do you really start verifying such complex software? Looks a very difficult problem. But how are we approaching it? So go to the next slide. All of you know Boolean algebra? A and, or, not, all this you know, 1, 0, 1 and 1 is 1, 1 and 0 is 0, all that we know. Then we said that now these systems, which are automotive systems, are sequential system. This happens, then that happens, then that happens, then that happens, and the system goes on working. So first thing we defined was, we added onto Boolean algebra four more operators. First one said that if there is an infinite sequence and something is true at a state, so say that P means red color. P means red color. So something is true at a state, then if it is true on every sequence on that, every state on that infinite sequence, we say GP, which means globally P. Got it? If it is true somewhere, at least once, we say in future P. If it is true in the next state, we say XP, next state P. And so on and so forth. If it is true, say it says P, 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 Q, not P, 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 C. P, 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 Q, then we say P is true until Q becomes true. So these four simple operators we added. Globally, previously Boolean algebra is there. Now on a sequence, four operators were added. And just look at the interesting thing what four operators do. What is GP? Globally P. So GP means P holds always, which means not P. That never holds, which means not P holds is not true, which is the same as not of F of not of P, which means in future not P is not true. What does this law look like? Doesn't this law look like De Morgan's laws? Doesn't this law look like De Morgan's law? Not of A and B is the same as not A or not B. So the F and the G flip. And from these simple ideas, you get magic. And once you get magic, next, then you get some funny things. What is FGP? In future, so there is some point in the future from where P continues to hold. What is GFP? GF, not GF, not normal GF. GFP means globally, for in every state, in future P holds. From the next state, in future P holds. From the next state, in future P holds. Which means what? P holds infinitely often, but may not be in every state. It goes on holding. So using the foundations of such simple things, we started writing out how we should verify the behavior of an automotive system. So when a brake is applied, the car should immediately decelerate. So you can check whether the brake is pushed. You can check whether the car has decelerated from the previous state. So we write down globally, if brake, then in the next state, deceleration should happen. I'm giving you some cartoonish ideas. When the brake is applied, then the car begins to decelerate within 20 milliseconds. We started writing this down. When the brake is pressed, then the car decelerates within 20 milliseconds, either by throttle adjustment or by brake adjustment. Then if the brake is pressed for more than 3 seconds, the car eventually stops. So we figured out that you can now start writing the properties of the behavior of a system like this in logic. And then you can not only specify the system, you can start looking at the software and checking whether that software adheres to these properties or not. I'm showing you very simple things. But, and we sat with Intel, we sat with General Motors for 5 years. General Motors had an interesting problem. When there was a crash, in some of the vehicles, instead of the airbag coming out, the airbag was coming out, along with that, the CD player was also coming out. And we were able to check why it was happening through all these funny things. And I was very delighted to see when my colleague Pallab Dasgupta, he bought a new car. He's my colleague. We work on this problem all the time. You know, students do all the problems. Faculty gets the credit. You know, these are good things which are happening. So he bought a new car. And he was saying, hey, PPC, can you see? Now I have this, that. You remember we were writing out all these properties? And they have now come in the car? You can imagine the excitement. They did not give us any money, but anyway. They did not even give us a car. No, they gave us a car to test and run. It didn't come with the wheels. They said, we cannot give you a car with the wheels. Then there is income tax problem, that problem, that problem. So finally, they gave us a car without the wheels. You say you buy the wheels separately. So there is some Indian laws which prevent you to do all that. So anyway, we can figure out. The good thing was, you can imagine. So what I'm just trying to tell you is that from any problem tackled from simple scientific ideas, I'm not showing you the whole story. There are 3-4 stories I can relate to you on different topics that we have done. Done completely in India. Taken the research of the best companies in the world and done it in India. And that has led to actual results. We have letters from these companies saying, this is the first time in the history of Intel that a research result and an eventual tool has gone into production in 2 years. So the basic science and the relentless pursuit till the very end, and enjoying it all the time, enjoying the failure, enjoying the success, and all these things are very, very helpful. And then next. So what we are now trying to, previous, now what we are trying to do, now then we got very excited. Then we are trying to say that instead of checking correctness, just from those formula, we are trying to define how much power this system will take, how reliable this system will be. And today as we go on now, we are modeling systems at this level of logic and analyzing it just not for its functional correctness, just not for its performance, but for its reliability, for its power, and doing crazy sort of things. It leads to extremely new types of mathematics that we have to solve, new types of ways of writing programs, new methods of testing hardware, and you really have to start learning new things to start doing them. So that is something that is very, very important to do in research. We discovered it the hard way by doing it ourselves, by failing hundreds of times, and then getting up and again trying, and going on doing it relentlessly. Next. And then I still have this big dream that tomorrow, building design, bridge design, materials design, biology design, multidimensional, multiphysics modeling, I will be able to determine an integrated mathematics for that. The mathematics which will translate into correct by construction mechanisms. We started doing it for analog systems now, and it's a dream, and we will pursue it relentlessly. Good student, bad student, does not matter. My office staff, they all know that after 8:30 in my office, in the director's office, one cup of tea, and he waits till 10 o'clock for filing up all those. I don't listen to anybody else. Only my students or I am alone. Just thinking. Clearing my head off all the nasty things I have done, whom I have suspended, you know, all that whole day, bad things. Clearing my head. And again, looking at this, looking at it and dreaming, what next? Next, please. And the latest Nature report tells you that today, the IITs, among the Indian institutions, the IITs have taken over all institutions in research. We are now the number one as the IIT system in terms of research output. So the onus is now on y'all to go beyond and take it forward. Next. For y'all, the situation is a little different. We came through the system and started learning the grand challenges. You all are told the grand challenges. I'll show you what you all are told. Just click that title there. Click, click.
The question is, what do we want from the future? What quality of life do we want for ourselves and for future generations? And whether we can actually attend to our behaviours and change them, it may be too difficult to do, but that would be pretty disappointing.
Provide energy, keep a clean environment, allow people all over the world to come up the scale of prosperity and health, provide them with food, clothing, shelter, and clean water.
How can we have our cake and eat it too, if you will? How to accomplish the good things and minimize the bad.
It is the system that keeps us, you know, digging bigger holes and putting more trash in them and putting it into the ocean. And if we think about what we actually do and the amount of products you use every day and the things you throw away, it's quite extraordinary.
Making a transition to a more sustainable planet is the ultimate challenge for all of us today.
We want to tackle really important societal problems. And of course, that does require putting together basic science, engineering, end users.
The challenge for me tries to address the issue of societal wealth, how to maintain it into the future, in particular how so-called developing world can increase their standard of living, and yet...
So, what I want to tell you is that today, we were not given all these grand challenges of earth, water, the most important things that are relevant and important for you to do research. We were always told, try to do something good, try to do something simple and nice. But as we have gone up the hard way, and those people there represent some of the people like us, I didn't want to tell it to you, I just wanted to show you a picture of the grand challenges that we talk about in India or anywhere in the world, that research becomes focused, directed. I used to see this statement of Mahatma Ji on the railway stations, this talisman. If you are doing something, try to make sure that even the poorest of the poor in the country. So since I was doing this Boolean logic algebra, what poorest of the poor, what will he do? So I used to go like this and go away. But you cannot avoid it anymore. You cannot avoid it anymore. For you, the change has come. The foundations are built. And as I said, that fourth row of the cricketer benchmark is what we are looking for from you. Next. What are the difficulties of your time? First difficulty, we have become supervisors. Come to my office, are you doing research? You know, and and we start talking, what is the relevance of your research? So we have put you in a lot of problems. But we have done it with good intentions. We have done it with good intentions. Now it has become very easy to compare with what is world class. For us, it was nothing. There was no comparison. You did it. Then you sent the paper somewhere. Lot of red color. All this is done 20 years ago, came back. Now you put it on the internet. You know very quickly. You know what is world class. And then you try to sneak in a paper knowing that what you have done is not even third world class. That you should not. One thing that people are trying to take now is the easy middle path. You're trying to tell somebody that I'm doing theory. So he then asks three fundamental questions. He says, no, not theory. So I'm actually doing an implementation to test the theory. So somebody said, you're doing this implementation, but this implementation is not true real life. He says, yeah, I'm doing concept modeling. You go and tell ISRO, I'm doing concept modeling. You have to take that Mars orbiter up. You have to take the rocket up and it has to work. Concept modeling, and then push, it happens like this all the time. That concept, your concept will also go. So either you do real fundamental work, or you really get down to the details and do a real demonstration. That middle way, where you neither do the fundamental work nor you do the real demonstration, is not only cheating others, it's cheating yourself. And everybody is quiet because most of us are already doing that. No? And as I said, there is the big ethics challenge. Firstly, you all don't, the ethics scenario has become so complicated that most of us are not aware of what is right and wrong. Secondly, once we try to move up in the chain ladder, then these Americans try to tell us what is wrong because, you know, so that they can get us down. They have done it themselves, but they will tell you are wrong. They'll find ways. But even then, this foundational ethics issue is an issue where at your heart, you must be very careful about. I cannot teach ethics. I just cannot teach ethics to you. Just a little while ago, in the morning, we had this Guru Paduka Stotram, which was noted. If you have a problem with ethics, then pick up your hero of your life and look at that person for some time. Just look at that person for some time and decide what you should do. We in India have to battle against large research groups in the West and other places. We are all in our silos, as it was just pointed out. We hardly know each other's research. We really don't know what to do. We don't talk to each other. My work, my paper, my this. Narrow, and then when you go for a job, you know nothing. That one element, one item, one thing. I remember a guy who came to give an interview for construction engineering. I said, good. He said, a lot of theory he taught me. He said, I've done this, that. I said, I've given you a 10-foot culvert. You give me the design for the 10-foot culvert. He said, I've come to do research. If you cannot design a 10-foot culvert, no point doing any research. Then you all have become multitasking. One window Facebook, one window this one. Attention span for research has become very little. You all do too many things, and research requires long time on a single item. And that is becoming a cultural issue. Deep down, deeply thinking for long hours is not turning out to be because of this multitasking scenario. And you all also have to go on hunger strike. We also had very low scholarship. My professor is telling, Ari, I don't see you in the first half. I said, sir, the scholarship that you have given, I will come only one half. The other half, I will not come. Achcha, you have a scholarship problem. Let me find out what to do. So, you know, next. Now for y'all, am I taking too much time? Okay. When you are in research, this question, when you are entering, while you are doing, and at the end of the day, you should ask yourself why you have come to do research. Answer is job. Is that the answer? So, how would I tackle it? I used to read a lot of books. And then I made this small video for you, which now, once in a while, I myself look at for some time. So that's to get back to the roots of why I want to do research. This is not related to any research in any of the scientific topics. But it will give you an idea, and I don't want to even explain it to you. It will give you an idea of something that I want to share with you. I've done a copy paste from several places and built it up. Click on that first one. Please look at it with some silence in your heart.
Jal
mein
boond.
Nahi aa raha.
To boond bhi jal.
No.
Aag mein chingari. To chingari mein bhi aag.
Full screen.
Boond jal mein. Jal dhara mein. Dhara ganga mein. Ganga sagar mein. To sagar. Sagar kis mein? क्या बादल में क्या आकाश में बूंद फिर बादल में बूंद फिर जल में तो फिर मैं कहां से आता हूं मैं कहां जाता हूं कुछ समझ में नहीं आ रहा
फिर आकाश से बातें कर रहा है
काका नदी के दो तट हैं तो क्या हमारा भी कोई दूसरा तट है?
पगला देगा तू मुझे? ले पकड़ पत्तल का दोना। हमारे लिए यही पहला और यही आखिरी सच है। यही प्राण है, यही ईश्वर है।
जल इसमें भी है, आग इसमें भी है। अगर यही प्राण और यही ईश्वर है तो फिर वो आकाश में भी है, धरती में भी है।
अरे मैं तेरे हाथ जोड़ता हूँ, तेरे पांव पड़ता हूँ, मुझसे ये सवाल न किया कर, मैं पागल होना नहीं चाहता।
मैं सत्यकाम जाबाला का पुत्र हूँ, मेरा नाम सत्यकाम जाबाल है।
जाबाला का पुत्र? तेरी माँ को यहाँ कौन नहीं जानता? चल दूर हो जा यहाँ से। क्यों आचार्य के मार्ग को अपवित्र कर रहा है?
सत्यकाम, जा यज्ञ की संविधा ले आ। आज से तू मेरा शिष्य और मैं तेरा आचार्य। आज से तू जबाला का पुत्र, हरि द्रुमद गौतम के शिष्य के रूप में जाना जाएगा। जा, जल्दी जा, तेरे उपनयन संस्कार के लिए यज्ञ की संविधा ले आ।
मरे हुए मनुष्यों के संबंध में कुछ लोग कहते हैं कि वे हैं और कुछ लोग कहते हैं कि वे नहीं हैं। मैं उस सत्य को जानना चाहता हूँ। हे मृत्यु, मैं उस रहस्य को जानना चाहता हूँ जिसे न जानने के कारण मेरे निष्प्रिय और तपस्वी पिता भी मोह के बंधन न काट सके। क्या है जीवन की उपासना का वह रहस्य जिसे मनीषी आत्मविद्या कहते हैं? हे अंतक, ये सुख ये भोग कल रहेंगे या नहीं इसका भरोसा नहीं है। भोग से इंद्रियों का तेज कम होता है, इसलिए आपके ये घोड़े ये नाच ये गान आप अपने पास ही रहने दें। नवित्तेन तर्पणियों मनुष्य, मनुष्य के धन की प्यास कभी बुझने वाली नहीं, इसलिए मुझे तो आप वही ज्ञान दें जिसे पाकर मनुष्य अमर हो जाए।
जस्ट टू गिव यू एन आइडिया, the thirst for knowledge will get you to your true supervisor, maybe external, maybe internal. And for that you have to ask fundamental questions. And this must be there deep in your heart. Otherwise, the research that you have come for will not be sustaining in your life. The next is, whose PhD you are carrying out? You know, there are these supervisors who have to supervise 2 PhDs or they won't get promotion. They will call you, do this, do that, do this, do that. It is their PhD, not your PhD. Then there is the other kind. My colleague, as I mentioned, Professor Pallav Das Gupta, his first PhD student was a senior person. So he says, PPC, please be co-guide. I have to manage a senior person. So I said, okay. So one day he says that, please come, we are going to have a research meeting. I said, fine. So I went in Pallab's room, and I'm sitting down there in his room, and I'm seeing, Pallab is explaining. So now, FGP, so that other person is saying, then that what happens? So Pallab is saying, then this. Then he's saying, then how will that work? So I observed for 10 minutes. I didn't say anything. Then I told that person, come and meet me in my room. So he came to my room. And then I told him that you will not get your PhD this way. But sir, we are solving a very important problem. But I said that I have to sign, na? I will write that it is Pallab Das Gupta's PhD thesis, not your thesis. So he says, then what will happen? I said, first go and make sure that it is your thesis, otherwise I will not sign. So he said, what will I do? I said, you think what you will do? Then my other student said, what have you done to him? He's chain smoking out there. He has said, my life is gone, everything is over. this fellow is a demon and he has destroyed my PhD, etc., etc. Ab to kabhi nahi hoga. Then I said, don't worry. After 2 days, he says, sir, I want to go home. I said, go. Then he came back happy and started doing his research. So I said that, tum kya kiya? Sir, Kamaksha mein jaake ek puja deke aaya, sir. Do something, get back on your feet and do your own research. So who is doing the research? Do you know the subject matter? Are you dreaming about your research? So let me share with you. People say, you know, people think that you should dream, etc., etc. And let me tell you something from my own life. There was one problem that I was solving. One algorithm, and I was not able to do it. And as we said, you know, we never used to come in the first half. Scholarship was low. So we used to work till late night and sleep. And so this problem I was trying to solve for a long, long time. Not coming. A very crucial part of the algorithm. Then, you know, we used to eat, friends together used to eat. One of my research scholar friends was married, so that was useful. His wife was a good cook. So we used to eat there also. So one day, late in the night I worked, I was thinking of some other problem. And then every night I used to, because that was my favorite problem, I used to think about it a little. How to do it, not coming. And then next day, in the morning, something very interesting happened. I was lying on the bed. I woke up. My body was sleeping. My mind was awake. And believe me, I saw a figure of how that algorithm will work in a diagram. This step will happen, this step will happen, this step will happen, this step will happen. And then my limbs became a little loose. I got up, wrote that diagram, I realized that the problem is solved. And I put that diagram in that paper. That is my most cited paper ever. So dream, dream, it works. It works. It works. Did you get a heartbreak? Yes. Sent a paper. People said, it is done. Just a few days ago, we solved an extremely interesting problem, did a very great mathematics on a reliability problem. We were so overjoyed. We wrote the whole paper out, and then some gut feeling, you know, when you dream about problems, gut feelings happen. I told Aritro, this looks too simple and too beautiful for somebody not to have done it before. Look at it, look at it. He said, sir, I have searched everything. Finally, see, the internet is so powerful. Finally, we almost had sent the paper. He sent me an SMS, sir, found it, 1968. But we were delighted that we had done it all by ourselves. And we used that same concept and did something different, that same philosophy, and we got another workout in a different area, but it helped us. So you will get heartbreaks. And you'll have to find your own ways to get over it. Can you explain your research to others? That is the most important thing. Two categories. One is really people authoritative in the field, can you explain it to them? The second is to a layperson. Some idea, if you cannot do that, then it becomes a little difficult to understand. So sometimes you must do that. And do you know the research problems of others? If you don't, then your problem. Next. So then I am willing to write a PhD for dummies. You know, how to get a PhD in 3.5 years? First, find a supervisor. How do you find a supervisor? Department allocates. How do you find a supervisor? You all can choose, no? So how do you find a supervisor? A person who does your PhD for you, or you know. And then how do you find a topic? The easiest way to find a topic is what is trending, you know, Twitter trending types. And trying to tweak it and write some papers. At least find a topic. For that topic, you start studying. Know it, know that topic well. And unless you know that topic well, you must have heard Dr. Vidyasagar coming and explaining things to you. He's a master of control systems. And because of his great knowledge of control systems, he has used that whole theory in biology. And today, the field of biology is transformed. So your topic must be something that you really do on your own. So first search, then e-search, www, Google, Google Scholar, SciFinder Index. So make sure you know the field well. Read, read. Nowadays, people don't read anything except their own papers. So be careful, because nobody possibly is reading your paper. But you must start identifying the good things and reading it. And then look at the problem again your way. Look at the same problem your way. You may be very foolish. Try 2-3 times. And then you'll get the handle. That's how we got it. We were looking like fools many times. This is wrong. Everybody would say, teach supervisor, no, no, this is too simple. What are you saying? This theory doesn't work. But then slowly, slowly, you'll get a handle to it. How many problems will you solve for doing a PhD? For dummies, 3. First one, let your supervisor define it and work with your supervisor to solve the problem. Second one, if your supervisor even defines or gives you the problem, solve it on your own. Third one, define that problem yourself. And talk to your supervisor and solve it on your own. And if it is good, if you are good enough, then for the fourth one, define the problem. Don't tell your supervisor. At the end, you go and tell him that I have done it. How does it look like? That is when you are ready to do your PhD. And make sure the experiments and results are all correct. Please don't fudge the results. Please don't fudge the results. And make sure you are convinced in your own heart that the experiments are correct. And a thesis does not mean you have to only do new things. If you did something which did not work and you have an explanation for why it did not work, even that is part of what a thesis is all about. When and where to publish, I just explained to you. Try to look at the best journals to publish, best places to publish, and then see what reviews you get. When to submit. So there are a lot of theories about when to submit. I will share with you my experience with one of my students. So he came and said, sir, hum thesis submit kam karenge. So I told him, you will know when you have to submit your thesis. No, sir, but you have to tell me. I said, no, you will know when you have to submit your thesis. So then he said, no, no, sir, you have to tell me when I will be ready to submit the thesis. So I told him, the day you realize that on this topic you know more than me, then you are ready to submit your thesis. He says, sab ki to kabhi nahi hoga sir, you are PPC, you are great guy. So, no, every day when I go to sleep and when I wake up, two prayers I have. That don't be gassed by others. You know what you are and be careful about what you are. Don't make sure that the others fool you to believe what they think you are is what you are. You are not that. So anyway, so that person, he said, ye to kabhi nahi hoga, sir, this will never happen. So I said, nahi, nahi, you will realize. So the day he came to submit his thesis, sir, sign karna. He's working in a good company, he's a great guy. So I'm signing. So I said, Subrat, you remember? He said, yes, sir. Are you ready to submit your thesis? He said, yes, sir. Is my rule correct, what I told you about? He kept quiet for 2 minutes. And then he said, yes, sir. I know more about this than you. And I'm sure that I know more about this than you. That is when you have to submit. And please make sure that you are doing teaching. If you are not teaching others, including your supervisor at times, then you are really not doing a service to yourself. You may not be knowing your work unless you start explaining to others what your work is all about. Next. Final gyan. There are great success stories. But you all, the next generation, for this country, for the sake of the people of this country, we are getting 25,000, 28,000. From where? Where are you getting that money from? From that person who buys a matchbox to light up the fire of his own homes for that one day meal, from that sale tax of that matchbox, from the poorest of the poor who buy things, the nation is giving you money in the hope that you will do something for them. Please remember, we all think we deserve all this money. Where is this money coming from? So it is time that the hopes of the nation are with you. And for India, it is time has come for all of you to network together and take on the most challenging problems. And you can only do this when all the IIT scholars come, define these 20 problems and work relentlessly for the next 5-6 years. Can you change this mindset? Can we really take on the world? If ISRO, with that motley of scientists, can change it, what would these IITs do? The 10,000 research scholars in the IITs do? Collaborate, compete, share, use the network. You tell us what you need. Tell us what you need. We may be fossilized. We may have become old. But that dream is still there with us. You know, there are parents who are not educated, but they dream to see their children educated. We have done our bit, but our dream is not successful yet. We will continue to try, and we want you to take this dream forward, dream yourself, and take it forward. Next. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir, for making us understand the word research in total innovative way. I thank you again for taking us to the roots of life. I hope the researchers will certainly imbibe your suggestion into their research work. We heartily thank you, sir.